Good morning students. In the previous class we have discussed about different kinds of nutrients and their uses. So today we are going to discuss further. It is not necessary that one particular food item will contain only one kind of nutrient. Actually, if we are saying that a potato is a carbohydrate rich food, means the quantity of carbohydrates present in it is more. It may also contain some other nutrients. Maybe some proteins, calcium, some other nutrients also, some minerals also present in it. Similarly, for example, milk consists of many nutrients. It consists of calcium, it consists of phosphorus, it consists of proteins also. So, one food item may contain multiple nutrients. Okay. Besides these nutrients, we also require dietary fiber and water. Today, we are going to discuss about them one by one. First, dietary fiber. What is a dietary fiber? Dietary fiber is also known as rafels. Dietary fiber, it consists of undigestible fibrous food material. Particularly, we get this dietary fiber from plant products. It mainly consists of cellulose, which is an undigestible fibrous material. It helps in the, you see, dietary fiber is undigestible fibrous material present in our food. It is also known as rafel. It helps in the smooth removal of undigested food. It prevents constipation. And we get dietary fibers from fresh fruits, vegetables, cloves, pulses, potatoes, etc. So, it keeps our digestive system normal. Okay? So, it helps in the proper functioning of the digestive system. Next, let us move to another part, that is water. Water helps in the removal of waste in the form of sweat and urine. You know, along with food, the second most important thing is water. Without water, we cannot even survive. It helps in the waste, that is in the form of liquid waste, that is urine and sweat. It also helps to absorb the nutrients present in the food. It prevents dehydration. Dehydration means when there is excessive loss of water from our body, it is known as dehydration. So, it also helps to maintain our skin healthy. And you know, water is not only present in the water what we are drinking, it is also present in the fruits and vegetables which you eat. You cut any fruit or vegetable, you will see inside some wet content, that is liquid content is there. Along with that, we add in the food items which we cook. Different food items, curries we prepare, we add water to that. So in this way, even milk, fruit juices, other things also, water, liquid content is going into our body. So water is added by different means to our body. Now, let us look at another point, that is balanced diet. Before going to a balanced diet, we should know what is diet. A diet means the food which is taken by a person for a day, that is known as diet. The diet which contains all the nutrients in right quantities or right proportion, that is known as balanced diet. A diet which contains all the nutrients required by our body in right proportion or right quantities. Is known as balanced diet. Balanced diet means we should take a food item which should consist of both energy-giving food, body-building food, protective food, along with dietary fiber or roughage and water, so that all the nutrients should go inside our body, in our food item. Then only it will be known as balanced diet. You know, the balanced diet for all the people will not be same. That is, the needs, it depends upon our age as well as the amount of physical work we are doing in a day. So, the balanced diet will not be same for all the people. Okay? And second thing, we think that balanced diet means it will be expensive, but it is not true. We can get balanced diet with very less cost also. Means from our pulses, soya beans, sprouted greens like sprouted moong seeds, jaggery, sattu, okay, and South Indian food, fermented foods like idlis, or we may get your Gujarati food, your like thepla, misi roti. These all contain nutrients in large quantity, at the same time their cost will be less. So we can get balanced diet with less cost. Okay, so it is not only necessary that the diet which is should be cooked properly, also to retain the vitamins and nutrients in our diet, we should take certain precautions means certain care, certain steps we must be careful while cooking and during its preparation. Like, we should not wash the vegetables after peeling or cutting them, because if we wash the vegetables after peeling or cutting them, the minerals or the nutrients present in it, the vitamins present in it will be washed away. Similarly, we should not wash the rice and pulses before cooking many times. So, because many proteins and many nutrients present in it will be washed away. Similarly, the food items should not be overheated or overboiled. Means when we heat it, certain vitamins and nutrients present in it will evaporate, like the vitamin C. It evaporates when it is heated. So in our diet, we should include some fresh fruits and vegetables like salads, so that it will be helpful for our body. And we should not, we should not pour more water in our food item while cooking. So, or we should not drain out after, we should not drain out the water after boiling. Like some people, what they do, they take out the boiled rice juice after cooking from the rice. So, when we drain out, many proteins, many starch proteins present in that particular food item will be taken away from that particular food item. So we should take care of these steps so that our food will be healthy and it will be a balanced food item. And at the same time, you should take care that you should not waste food, because there are many people in the world who are not getting a proper meal in a day. So we should all take care that we should not waste our food items. Thank you.